We're here with Get Glam, and we're talking with Jess Zaino. Mm-hmm. I kind of came up with the thing that you are the empress of looking glam affordably.
Wow, thanks, empress.
The empress. The queen, I thought, no, empress. Empress, right? It was kind of apropos with the Chinese Olympics going on right now. Tell us, Jess, how can we get glam fashion style without spending a fortune?
Well, there are some really easy things that you can do. As easy as red lipstick. If you get your favorite red lipstick, mine personally is Max Russian Red, which was made for Madonna on one of her world tours by Gaultier.
Wow.
So if you just put a dash of that on your lips, your teeth look whiter,
okay.
Your face pops, and literally for probably about what is the stick cost, $24, you can get glam. And it's the easiest thing and takes less than 10 seconds.
Well worth $24.
I totally agree. You can get glam by something very simple, which is a trend that's emerging right now, which are belts. So if you take a cute blousy dress or a cute blousy shirt, that probably costs, what, $17? And then you actually spend the money on a great belt, whether that's $25, $35, or if you want to go all out and get the one that Sarah Jessica Parker wore in the movie Sex and the City that Patricia Field designed. I believe that one is $110. On Patricia Field's website. But you can belt anything, give yourself a waist, add a completely different layer to your look, and look glam in no time for less.
From 20 to 110 bucks. I like that, very affordable. You are the empress.
Something that's really easy, again, that doesn't take a lot of time, is if you're going to work, chandelier earrings are not appropriate at work. So what you want to do is keep some in a little plastic baggie in either your bag or your car, so that if you're ever going from day to night, leaving the office, heading to a party, heading to cocktails, heading to meet friends, you throw on a pair of great chandelier earrings that, again, you can get at like a Target for $12, and you instantly look glam. People will comment on those earrings, and they're really a statement piece of style. Another easy tip to get glam in no time and also for less is to purchase jeans that are dark wash. So instead of wearing like a light wash jean or a ripped jean, if you get a very dark wash jean, it's both slimming, but also could be worn as something that is considered cocktail. You know, denim is really the new trouser these days. So instead of wearing some outrageous outfit, pair a cute top with some dark wash jeans, and you'll look glam in no time. Another fun trick is to take a brooch, either your grandmother's brooch, a big pin from a vintage store or a Goodwill, and to pair it on just a simple white t-shirt. If you take a white tank top, if you go to Target, pick up Hanes men's tank tops that come in packs of six for $7.99, throw on one of those with your dark wash jeans and add some really fun brooch or pin that you found at the Goodwill for 50 cents, immediately glam up a look.
Oh my gosh. So what? Now if we put all these together, would that be too much? If we had red lipstick and the brooch and the belt and the... That might be a little bit too much.
Well, you just want to be careful. Coco Chanel said you should always put on all of your accessories and then take one off.
Ah, okay.
So put on everything. Put on the red lipstick. Put on the brooch. Put on the jeans. Maybe take off the belt.
Okay.
And I think you'll be good to go.
Oh, that's fabulous. How do we become like you and become our own trendsetter?
Well, I don't think you want to become like me. What people want to do is stay true to their own selves. So the most important rule of style, I always believe, is you just want to love yourself. Ultimately, that doesn't cost a thing. If you love yourself and really own your own style, all of your choices will come from who you are and how you want to express that. From that, of course, comes the the tricks of the trade, which are you go through all of the fashion magazines and do magazine tears.
Right.
So take out pictures that you like the look of that and try to duplicate it at the store. To this day, I'm a working celebrity stylist, and I have an envelope filled with pictures that I tear out of magazines just so that when I go to the store, if I liked the look, I can create it. Look at the red carpet looks of celebrities that you like. You know, if there's a celebrity that you may look like, see what colors they use or see what hair cut they have for their shape face. So that it's just paying attention to pop culture and then infusing it with your own style to be as glamorous as you want to be.
And as original, too.
And as original, yes.
Yes, that's great. Can you tell us also a little bit about your blog?
Yeah,
I love a blog.
Sure, I have a website. It's jess-zaino.com, which is me. And from it, I do blog probably about like 3, 4, 5 times a week. Wow. My blog is connected to my MySpace, which has 3,000 friends on it. And I really like to keep people informed on whatever trendy little things I pick up, whether it's in my travels to my hometown in New York, whether it's here in LA, whether I'm going abroad to Switzerland, Mexico, wherever. I like to write about some of the fun trends that I find on my blog, Trendster.
Okay.
So it's super fun, and a lot of people get into it because I definitely have my own voice when it comes to making trends or setting trends, and I love to do it.
Oh, that's great. Style. Well, I can tell. I can tell by interviewing you and then reading your stuff. It's just very, very engaging.
Yeah. And you can also see me every Thursday night on VH1 on Glam God with Vivica A. Fox.
Fabulous. Well, we look forward to it, and thank you so much for doing our episode for Get Glam.
Thanks.
You've been watching Get Glam from itsaglamthing.com.